Good morning, everyone. Myself, Apurva Gupta. She is Rukaiya and she is Riddhi. We are from NG Third Eye and Analytic Tool Group. Now, the first thing is what motivated us to take this project. The first thing is we need a tool which can analyze any kind of database. The tool must be able to perform data analysis, statistical analysis of data, and plot the graph on the fly. The tool must also provide support for various type of graphs. It must be able to create a report, and we must be able to see the report in future whenever it is needed. Now, you might be having question, why this tool? There are already some tools available in the net or in the market. So my answer to this is, most of the tools get a CSV file, but they do not apply any of the conditions of this on the CSV file. Some tools are not open source, some do not provide offline support, and some are for a licensed or for a limited period of time you are provided the access to them. So our tool is better than these tools in this way. So I'll start with what are the features of our tool. First, our tool plots graphs based on the target data. By target data, I mean is if you are a teacher, you know, and you want to plot the graph between two parameters. You want name of the student on x-axis and marks of a particular subject on y-axis. So without any manual effort, you just need to select the values or select the particular columns from our user interface, and the corresponding graph will be shown selecting the particular graph type. The second is we have provided various filtrations and conditions. By filtrations, I mean that I want to plot a graph of only those students whose name starts with P, contains P, ends P, or any other thing like that. Conditions like we can say marks of a student are greater than 80, less than 80, or any other such numerical conditions. So basically, this is about string filtrations and conditions. It also supports logical operators. Now the next feature, it is not applied to a single table. It also supports relational tables. And a table can be related to any number of tables, and the corresponding graph can be plotted on the basis of those relational tables. Moreover, the filtrations are also provided. The same features we are providing on a single table, we are also providing them on related tables. The next feature is whatever we are doing till now is we are providing the data, we are plotting the graphs. This tool also provides a provision. We can save the graphs as well. The graphs will be saved in a form of report, and along with the corresponding graph, a table will be shown. So we can perform the analysis in the way we want. Moreover, we have implemented many more graphs like line, pie, bar, waterfall graphs, and that we will show in the demo what graphs we have taken up. The next feature is import a CSV file. Rather than plotting the graph on the data which is already there, we can import a CSV file, add it on, and we can plot the graph for that CSV file as well. The next is PDF support download. The graphs can be downloaded in the form of a JPG image, PNG image, as well as in a PDF format. These are some of the technologies we used in our project: PHP, JavaScript, AJAX, jQuery, HTML, and CSS. And we use Vue framework for its development. Now we will come up with the demo.
As you see, this is our homepage, and there are various tabs provided on the above. Now we'll show you some examples. Plot graph. This is the user interface, and on the left side you can see the drop-downs that we have provided. These are the tables from we'll be selecting. The first example is showing the relational table. The first we have selected enrollment table, and the enrollment table is related with the student table, and the student table is related with the assignment. So now we'll be selecting the course ID on the x-axis and the values of the x-axis. We are currently selecting all the x values, and currently we'll not show you with any of the conditions. The next example will come up with the conditions. We are plotting the graphs, the course ID with the assignment. Yes, sir. So the graph we'll be plotting is the first we'll show you the bar graph, and the second is the line graph. And the last and the third one that can be plotted is the pie graph as well. And this is the table, that is the corresponding table that we are dynamically generating by selecting the options that is provided, that we have selected. Now we'll saving the graph so that in future we can view the graph if we want. So the graph is being saved. The next example will come up with the function that is a group by function. So now we'll be selecting the table that is the courses and the course that is the department in the x-axis, and we'll be selecting all the values. And on the y-axis, we'll be plotting with the course number. And we are selecting the function that is a maximum function. This will actually plot the graph department versus course number. This is the maximum course number of a particular department. The graph is plotted, that is the area graph. Various graphs we have provided. We can plot pyramid graph, funnel graph as well. And we'll be saving the query again. The third example is we'll be applying conditions like greater than, less than, or equal to. So we'll be selecting the students. And on the x-axis, we are selecting the student names and all the students that are present in the table. And on the y-axis, we can select the whichever marks we want to plot. The condition will be between the ranges that can be greater than 50 or anything that can be that we will be using. We are showing greater than 50 and less than 80. We can use a logical operator as AND, OR, and XOR. So this is the bar graph, and this shows the marks which are greater than 50 and less than 80 between the range. This is the cumulative graph. This is the waterfall graph. And we'll be saving the query. Now we can show you the graphs that we have saved and that can be viewed. So this can be viewed, and initially it will show the graph while the graph which have been saved initially. So this was the waterfall graph that we have saved, and on the user interface we have given options. Various graphs can be plotted. Now we come up with the CSV upload. What we have done here is we are uploading a CSV file with the data. And when we upload it, this is the user interface where we are generating the columns, the number of columns which are in the CSV file. So there are four columns. So we are creating table. These are the columns that are available in the CSV file. You can see on the right side. And as well as the data type of the each column. So when we when we create this table, this table will be generated dynamically in the user interface. If you want to plot graph, the table will be dynamically appear in the database. This was the table that we had created with the CSV file. So we are plotting the employee name versus the salary. So this is the pie chart you can see. So this was generated dynamically just by uploading the CSV file and by creating the table into the database.
Yes, sir. So it is dividing the 100%
into the sections.
We are not providing that. We are not grouping them on the basis of salary. We are just providing.
Dividing
dividing the employees on the basis of.
Okay. Give me a table. Acha, what is this? No. You have got to give a table. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Show me a table of which employee you have got 20,000, 30,000, 40,000.
Yes, sir.
Histogram or something like that.
Means you want to see the.
How many people have got 20,000, how many have got 30,000, the salary distribution.
You want to see the table, okay, fine.
Salary distribution?
Yes, sir.
I want to see in front of 10,000, I want to see 1, in front of 20,000, I want to see 3, in front of 30,000, I will want to see 3, in front of 40,000, I want to see 2.
No, sir, that count function is not, till now it is not available in our application. That mathematical operators like group average and till now, within the available time, we were not able to do that.
Why are you talking it, treating it as a mathematical operation? The way I look at it is, you are providing me, okay, a normal user, okay, of a front end by which I can generate SQL queries. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Now, count is a basic function of an SQL query. Okay, right. It's a basic function. So you should have provided that. Okay. Select so many count. I only want count. I don't want the full list. It's a very common SQL function. Correct. But since you're providing a way by which an SQL query can be done, you should have done that.
Sir, on the basis of group by grouping the employees by salary on and using count. We can do that particular thing.
Correct,
also.
But why that front end was not provided? Because the way I would have designed the system was, there are two, three ways in which the system can be designed. Okay, because that's another question I wanted to ask you. You started by saying there are so many other things and I'm the best. Correct?
Yes.
Perfectly fine. Everybody should say that.
Yes.
Okay. Prove it.
Sir,
where is the comparison between you and any other tool?
No,
similar
sir.
Tool.
So that, sir, the basic features which they are providing and we are providing.
Where is the comparison chart? Without that, I will not allow you to make any statement like that.
So this is always a bad thing, that saying that we are not a salesperson to compare with others and what feature we give another. Rather than you should talk on your positive point rather than talking on the negative points of other. So I also didn't like that slide saying that we have got this and somebody doesn't have this. Right? You should talk what you have. Don't talk about others.
No.
Focus yourself.
No. I differ. I think you should talk about it. If you go to any wiki site which compares things, okay, it has got a list of, either way, it has got a list of features here. It has got a list of products here. It says yes, no, yes, no. Where is that? Okay. Because that tells me how much you have covered. Everybody understands you've got 8 weeks, you've got 3 people, correct? But how much of a practical product which is available in the market, maybe licensed, it doesn't matter. That research you should have done.
Yes, okay. Sir, we have done that literature survey and on the basis of that only we are saying this.
So where is the proof? Where is the chart? That single wiki charts which is there in comparison to all wiki things, where is that chart? These are the features which everybody has. These are the features I have. It should be a subset. In 8 weeks, I cannot believe anybody saying I am better than others. Okay. Okay. And the simplest thing you have to do is, since you have got a CSV, okay, is Excel.
Yes.
How do you compare with Excel? Excel has got count. Excel has got all graphs. Excel has got something called a pivot table.
Yes, sir.
Correct. Which will give me all kinds of things. So how do you compare with Excel?
No, sir. We are not just comparing. We are saying that our tool provides this feature also. Then on the uploaded CSV, we can apply filtrations.
Yeah, but Excel is the other way around. I can say that this is the database. I will create an SV, feed it into Excel, and do all my analysis, which is what everybody does. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, but for that, I think that the manual effort will be more as compared to.
Yeah, that's okay. But I can do many more things, including count.
This can be taken as a follow-up.
That's okay.